Do your cameras clip through walls or have janky movement? Cameras are present in every game, and having a good one can make a big difference. So here's how you can make a good third-person camera that has smooth movement and collision detection. Here is our scene. We are going to be making a camera that will follow the player and orbit around it with the movement of the mouse. So let's open our player scene and take a look inside. The player scene have just a movement script and a collision shape. We'll be taking a look at that later. To make our camera able to detect collisions is very simple. We are going to add a new node and select the type Spring Arm 3D. Then we are going to add our camera 3D as a child of that. Select the Spring Arm 3D and bring its position up so the camera is focusing on the player's head. The Spring Arm 3D node is a very useful one. It shoots a raycast along its blue, positive z-axis and put all of its children's positions where it has hit something, or at the end of its length, the raycast distance. That's why we put our camera pointing backwards. So when the spring arm moves it, it will still be pointing at the player. We can change the collision layer to define what it's going to hit, or even use a shape instead of a ray to look for collisions. Now let's go and make our camera rotate. Select the spring arm node and create a new script. Let's give it a name, camera spring arm, and press create. We can create a very simple orbiting camera like this. Inside the ready function, we call input.setMouseMode to change the mouse mode to mouse mode capture. This will make our mouse invisible and lock it to the screen. And inside the unhandled input, we are going to be use the input event mouse motions event.relative variable that tells us how much the mouse moved between frames, and use that to decrement our node's rotations y and x angles. We also multiply it with the export variable mouse sensibility to adjust the speed. And let's not forget to adjust the spring length, the camera distance, to about 6 meters. And just like that, we get a simple orbiting camera with collisions. We can move our mouse to rotate the camera, and it won't clip through objects. But the problem we have now is that the camera won't stop rotating if you keep moving the mouse, which is not ideal. So let's fix that. To fix the rotation, we just need to clamp the angle values. We are going to clamp the X rotation, the vertical motion, between minus 90 degrees for the top and about 45 degrees for the bottom. We also wrap around the rotation.y value to keep the rotation between 0 and 360 degrees to avoid precision errors. These values will give us a very good locking angles for our rotations. We can't look down over 90 degrees, and we can't look up for more than 45. We can also improve the code and pass the rotation limits as export variables and use them as the clamp values. Using the add export range here, we can add a slider between minus 90 and 0, using 0.1 increments, and we use the radians as degrees properties. This allows us to use degrees as values inside the inspector, and it will be automatically converted to radians for the variable in code. So we don't need to manually convert them before using it for the rotation. Now we can easily adjust the camera limits. So if we put minus 45 degrees here, the camera won't be able to look down more than 45 degrees. But let's continue improving our camera, and now add the ability to zoom and unlock the mouse. First, open Project Settings and go into the Input Map tab to add our new key actions. We are going to add a Wheel Up, Wheel Down, and Toggle Mouse Capture actions. Find the newly created action and click on the plus button to add a key. Mouse over the first input field and just mouse wheel up to detect the key, then press OK. Now do the same for the Wheel Down action. And also add a key for our mouse toggle action. Mouse over the input field and let's press tab for its key. With that done, we can make changes to our script. To make the zoom work, we are just going to check for the wheel up and down actions and increase or decrease the spring length. And we are going to use the mouse toggle to set the mouse mode to visible or captured. This will allow us to unlock the mouse and use it for the menus. Let's now test it. We can freely zoom the camera. But if we press tab now, our camera is still moving while the mouse is unlocked. So let's fix that. We are just going to need to check if our mouse is captured before moving the camera. And now everything is working. We can unlock the mouse and move it around if we want to. But the camera movement is still stiff. And if we walk behind a wall, the cameras will just jump into position, which is quite jarring. So let's improve that. But before that, let me talk about the sponsor of this video, Brilliant. Brilliant is an online platform where you can learn new things by doing. It is filled with tons of interactive examples and lessons that can teach you how to think more critically. The vector scores, for example, can give you a very good insight on how vector math works, and it is full of examples that closely relate to games. If you are a beginner, it also gives you basic courses that will teach you logic using games. And if you are more advanced than that, it also covers topics such as applied programming with Python, AI, and data analysis. Brilliant will also help you keep your motivation by gamifying your learning journey, and give you feedback when completing lessons and reminders about your objectives. If you are interested to try it out, go to brilliant.org/octodemy to get yourself a free 30 days free trial, as well as a 20% discount off your annual membership subscription. Now back to our camera. To make your camera movement smooth, we are going to need to change our setup a bit. Right-click the Spring Arm 3D and select Reparent to New Node to create a new Node 3D parent. And we are going to name this Spring Arm Pivot. Then, reset the original Spring Arms transform and move its position back on the pivot nodes instead. Then drag the camera to be a child of the pivot and create a new Node 3D as a child of the spring arm instead, and name it Spring Position. Lastly, we are going to remove the Spring Arm script and drag it back to the pivot Node 3D instead. And to make it work again, let's open it. Change the extents to Node 3D and add an onReady var to get our Spring Arm node, and use it in those two lines. Now it should be working like before, but moving the Spring Position node instead of our camera. And we are going to use that to smoothly interpolate the camera's position. So let's create a new script for the camera named camera follow. In here, we just need an export variable for the spring position to follow, and alert power to set how fast the camera will follow to that point. In the process function, we lerp the position of the camera with the position of the spring and multiply delta by the lerp power to adjust the velocity. To finish the setup, dragging the spring position to the slot, and now our camera doesn't snap in place and will slowly move into position. Changing it to 6, we can get some better results. Let's also fix the ground clipping by selecting the spring arm node and creating a new sphere collision with the radius of 0.3. Much better. Now the camera doesn't clip as much, and moving behind balls is much more smoothly. Now that we have our camera working, we also need to adjust our movement. Right now, if I hold forward, our character will always move in the same direction, no matter how the camera is rotated. But it's really easy to fix that. Let's open our player script. We only need to add a single line, take the move direction vector, and rotate it by the camera's global rotation.y. Simple as that. Now our character can move along with the camera. And here are some extras and common problems you might find. If your camera is moving weirdly, randomly zooming into the object when you are rotating, you might need to adjust your collision layers. Make sure your player object is not in the same collision detection layer as the Spring Arm 3D. Now it's fixed. If you are trying to use this camera setup with an object that rotates, the camera will rotate with the object, which is not ideal. To fix that, select the Spring Arm Pivot and enable Top Level. This will make it ignore the parent's transform. Then, make sure to add a process function that updates its position to the player's position. Now the problem should be fixed, and it will properly follow the object. But that's it! A very simple third-person camera with collisions for your games. I hope you liked this video, and until next time!